Hello, my beauty addicts. Welcome back to another Sunday Loves and Duds. Woo! Sunday Loves and Duds. Woo! Okay, guys, so obviously it is not Sunday. My intentions were to film this on Sunday and get it up as soon as possible after I got back from my weekend of a lot of events, which kind of happened. I did get home. It was pretty late. It was about like 9:30, 10. I got everything set up, I filmed a video, and then I realized I never hit the record button. I was so mad and so exhausted that I just said forget it, because I knew if I was going to redo it, I was just going to screw it up and I was going to be mad at myself. So I said, you know what, just do it when you can. I'm sure everyone will understand, because it was by this time, it was already like 10:30. I had to get ready for work. I had to get my kid ready for camp the next day, and you know how Mondays are, it always drags. So I just said forget it, and I decided to do it now for you guys, so better late than never. So I wanted to show you guys what I have been loving this past week. There are new things in here that I am super excited, and the majority of them I am wearing today. So the first thing I want to show you guys is my nail polish. It is from that line called Strange Beautiful. Strange Beautiful. I've gotten these in subscription boxes. I think this one was from the BoxyCharm, the very last BoxyCharm I ever got, and it was the bridal one. So it was the month of June. It came with two different colors, and I don't know what this one is called, but it's like a beautiful sky blue. I really like this line. It's all natural, so you don't have that acetone scent to it. It's not supposed to be harmful for your nails. It's not those harsh chemicals in it. So it's all natural, which I do like. It's very opaque. The only thing I don't like about this line is the brush. The brush is a bit rough. So the first coat is kind of hard for me to put on, and this is just with two coats, but it has stayed on. I really like it. Comes in so many different colors. I do like the shape of it too. It's kind of not bulky, so I can get more and kind of line them up, and they seem nice. I have about six of these now, so I have quite of a collection going on, and I have darker colors, I have bright colors, and then I have my natural pastel colors. So this is one that I really have been enjoying this past week. Now I'm going to switch it up. I pulled out this Revlon Colorstay eyeliner in Blackberry. This is horrible on my waterline. I'm not going to recommend this for my waterline, but what I've been doing is putting this on my lower lash line and then smudging it out with an eyeshadow. So this is what it looks like. It is not black or brown. It is a deep plum color. It looks black on the camera, but it really is like a plummy color. It's Blackberry. So it's not your black and it's not your brown. It is retractable. This is like a drier formula, so it's really hard on your waterline, so I wouldn't recommend it. But for your lower lash line, upper lash line, I think this is really nice to smudge out. It really stays. I really like it. So this is something that I've been using this past week on my lower lash line, and I really have been enjoying it with the palette that I'll show you eventually. Now I'm gonna mix it all up. For my lips, I just wanted something that was gonna make my lips look fuller, but very easygoing, nothing too high maintenance. And I pulled out my Stila lip glaze in the color Hibiscus. Now, I know you either like these or you hate these. These are the retractable one. It comes with a brush, and this color is really pretty. It's kind of like a mauve-y with gold sparkle to it. So you can see it right there. It's really pretty. I have it on my lips right now. This is the only thing I have on. The formula is heavy, so if you don't like a heavy formula, you're not gonna like these. It's heavy. I don't feel the grit from the actual sparkle in here. It does last quite some time because it is heavy. It is a heavy formula. To some, this may be sticky, but it's not sticky compared to other brands that I have tried. So I don't mind this one. These just smell like a sweet scent. There's nothing, I can't pinpoint a specific scent that these have, but I really like this. If you cannot find this particular color, I know that Milani's new lip glosses that they came out, there's one called Luminous that I recently used in a tutorial. It is very similar to this. That one's more of a brown based, and this one's more of a mauve base, but they're both similar. So if you can't find that one, I would I recommend that one. So I've been really using this one. I really like it. And it's so easy to work with. I really do like it. Super easy to apply. You don't really need a mirror too much. And it stays on, as you can see. I really like it. Now, if I did not use the blush that came with the palette that I'm going to show you, because I wanted more of a deeper blush color, which is not what I'm wearing today, I have pulled out this Amazing Cosmetics blush, and this is in the matte version. It's called Pink Chocolate. I hauled this for my birthday. This is what it looks like. It is super beautiful. It's one of those fall colors. It reminds me of the e.l.f. Blushing Rose color. It may be very similar to that. So that's what this blush looks like. I have been using this paired with a palette that I'll be showing you. So if I did not want to wear what is in the palette, I just would pull this out and use it. It's just super nice. It's a really nice transition blush from the summer to the fall, or even from the fall to the summer. I really like this one. These you can find at Ulta. I found mine at Ulta. The texture of these is super soft. It's very, very soft. It kind of feels like a clay formula. It's really, really nice. I have one other one from this brand, and I really have been enjoying these. So this is the blush that I have been alternating with the palette that I will be showing you. So the palette that I gave in and purchased because everyone kept raving about it, and I do own one other palette like this, the one that came out last summer, the Aqua Lily one, and I really like that one a lot. That's the only other one that I really own of this, so I had to get the Tarte Rainforest After Dark palette. It's just a beautiful palette. So this is exactly what I am wearing on my face completely today. I am wearing the bronzer, I am wearing the highlight, and this specific blush. This blush is beautiful. It is completely matte. It is, how would I describe this one? This is more of a pinkier based color than the one I just recently showed you. It's a lot lighter, as you can see. It is completely matte. The highlight and the bronzer are ones that they repeat a lot in these palettes. It comes with this little plasticky thing that tells you Park Avenue Princess is the bronzer and Champagne is the highlight. This is one of my favorite highlights from Tarte. It also came in the Aqua Lilies. Like I said, this always comes in those palettes. So that's one of my favorite highlights. I love it. It's like a champagne-y goldy color. Now these eyeshadows are amazing. I am currently wearing, let me see if I can get the names for you guys. I am currently wearing Up to No Gold on my eyelids. As a transition color, I am wearing Don't Turn a Brown, which is this right here, I believe. I think so. Let me see. Oh, that's the one I'm wearing on my outer V. I'm sorry. Tangled Up to You is this one. Don't Turn Around is on my outer V. So that's what I'm wearing. And then as my brow bone highlight, I am wearing this one, which is Bare to Exposure. It's more like a pinky highlight, but it's completely matte. These are beautiful, you guys. If you are on the fence and you don't really own too much Tarte palettes, I would recommend these circle ones because they so much comes in for the price and they always are great. I am obsessed. Like this gold one, I love anything gold, bronze, metallic kind of. And this right here is up my alley. I love it. This purple one is beautiful. As you could see, like the pigmentation is there. I don't really need to do too much in here. Like I'm not even touching that much, and these are beautiful. This is definitely worth your money. I held off because I wasn't sure if I really wanted it, if I really need it. Not that I really need it, but if I really wanted it. But I'm so glad I did pick it up. I picked mine up at Ulta because Ulta is so close to me versus Sephora. That I just picked it up at Ulta. I am very thrilled with it. I think that if you are in the market for a new palette, I would definitely check that out. It is nice and travel friendly, and the packaging is really, really nice. It's different every time they come out with a different theme. It's really nice. So I enjoy these a lot. I'm not one to always jump on the Tarte bandwagon as far as eyeshadows, but when I do, I've been lucky enough to pick the ones that are very nice. So that is my Sunday loves. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for waiting for this. I know I did try my best to get it up on Sunday. It did not work out, but better late than never. So thank you guys so much. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful week. And don't forget that a smile is the best makeup a girl can wear. Bye guys.